Climb aboard to get started. Activate the locomotive control desk as indicated. We'll be coupling to the wagons ahead and then moving to the adjacent track to couple to the second set of wagons. Use the throttle lever. Reduce the power to zero. If you stop short, release the brake and apply power again. This locomotive is fitted with screw link couplings. These require the driver to leave the cab and manually couple the vehicles. Climb down from the cab and attach the coupling between the vehicles. Return to the driver's seat to deactivate the cab controls. It's now time to move to the adjacent track and couple to the remaining wagons. Set the controls as before in preparation to move. To move beyond the junctions ahead, set the direction of travel and apply power to get moving. Reduce the power to zero and allow the locomotive. If you stop short, release the brake and apply power again. Junctions in this yard are manually operated. This means they require the lever next to them to be moved by hand. Climb down from the cab, walk over, and operate the indicated manual junction lever. Reduce the power to zero and allow the locomotive to coast along the track. If you stop short, release the brake and apply power again. Climb down from the cab and attach the coupling between the vehicles. It's now time to run the locomotive around the train. On the way back to the cab, uncouple the wagons from the locomotive. Climb down from the cab, walk over, and operate the indicated manual junction lever. Climb down from the cab, walk over, and operate the indicated manual junction lever. Climb down from the cab and attach the coupling between the vehicles. Good work. That concludes this introduction. More details on the operation of this locomotive can be found in the manual.